tormented.
Shall we cut and run?
Excellent choice.
The tiny fiend, a quozzet. Wicked creatures often used as familiars.
Wait, you're not Illy. My master, tall, skinny, prick with ears. So, you're Shovel's master now. Fine. You slab of beef with nipples, moo! Ellie calls me Shovel. Don't like it? Change it. Don't care. So, what first, Master? Gutting locals? Raising the dead? Making them walk? Making them scream? Yes. Steal bodies, tear them, then Lily puts them back together. Again and again. When he wasn't horny for the book. Oh, book this, book that. He loves the book. Oh, Master should go see. Talk to the mirror, and remember, balsam, good for burns.
Still in control, just.
Speak your name.
A magic mirror. You've read all about them, but never seen one up close before.
I see you were shaped by darkness, not light. You are not Illantoth. If you are his ally, step forward and declare it. Only a true ally of Illantoth may pass. What think you of the Zolkir known as Zastan?
You recognize the name, of course. Anyone that knows of the Red Wizards would. Zastam is a powerful lich that rules the land of Thay. He drove many red wizards out of their ancestral home.
You are no Zolkir. But are you wise? Tell me, why might one use balsam ointment? Acceptable. Finally. If you could see anything in me, what would it be? You seek to survive. You seek power. Be welcome.
Traps. How considerate.
Always room for more. young cave bear, killed and stuffed before its teeth were fully grown.
Someone there? It's big, but still young. Heavens help the hunter if its mother caught them.
Into my pocket.
At least things have stayed interesting.
Oh? A spell shite! When the fisting starts, use the sparky magic to call Shovel. Let's kill everything.
No one.
Be careful. There are traps about. Someone doesn't like visitors.
Let's move. What am I to do?
I applaud your taste. One with the weave.
Keep a blade close.
Shouldn't have wished to live in more interesting times.
The book is locked tight with no visible keyhole, only an oval recess in the cover's mouth. You try to examine the book, but the longer you stare, the more those piercing amethyst eyes draw you in. You've seen similar books in wizards' libraries. A tome on Thayan magic. A rare and expensive find. But people have gone mad reading less dangerous texts.
Curious. Why don't you take a closer look? I'll observe from back here.
That looks terribly heavy. Why don't you let me carry it for you?
You don't know what he read, but it had an effect. His eyes are hungry, but pained.
Well, quite the page turner. I'll get back to it when I have more time to focus.
The book refuses to open. For you, at least.
Keep your distance, darling.
You feel its connection, its longing to be opened, to share its secrets. You open the book to the first page, with its shifting glyphs and strange whispers. The symbols dart beneath your eyes, warping and twisting. Your head throbs, but you almost understand. You is gone. You can only see those glyphs, only hear those voices. You feel claws moving in the shadows. They pull at you, dragging you closer. Glyphs scream, branding your mind with strange runes. You see time rewritten, fate undone, your future thrumming with power. The book snaps closed. You've seen too much. What profane knowledge is now seared inside of you, you should never have known.
All's well that ends, not as bad as it could have.